bias estimator. When we say bias estimator, there is bias, there is unbiased. When you use sample variance to estimate the population, you are going to get the population variance back. This one is called unbiased. But when you use population to estimate the population, this is the one we call a bias. Now, we know that our sigma square is equal to 1 over n summation x minus x bar square. So from here, we can introduce the mu, the population mu. We are going to have 1 over n summation x minus mu plus mu minus x bar square. What we have done here, if you look at it, is mu minus mu. We are still going to get this value back. Then we can now have our 1 over n summation x minus mu, I group them, minus x bar minus mu all square. We've not violated any mathematical rules from this place. If you expand this with minus, you still get this one back. Remember, when you are expanding a minus a b square, you are going to have something like this: a square minus 2ab plus a b square. So this one is the one denoting our a, while this one denoting our b. So if you expand this, you are going to have 1 over n summation x minus a mu square, that is our a square, minus 2ab, that's x minus mu. This is the b. We have x bar minus mu plus, this is our b square, that's x bar minus mu square. Now we can use this summation to expand the bracket. We are going to have 1 over n into summation x minus mu square minus 2 x bar minus mu summation x minus mu plus x bar minus mu square. We need to work on this aspect by using this summation to open here. We are going to have 1 over n into summation x minus mu square minus 2 into x bar minus mu. If we use this, we have summation x minus n mu plus x bar minus mu all square. This one, remember, when you have our x bar is same thing as summation x over n, so meaning our summation x is equal to n x bar when you cross multiply. Then we are going to replace this with that, so that you have a 1 over n into summation x minus mu square minus 2 x bar minus mu into n x bar minus n mu plus x bar minus mu square. Remember that we use this summation to open this. There will be n here, there will be n here, there will be n here, because there is no variable here. That's why we can't say summation x bar minus mu. Here there is variable, that's why we put summation x minus mu. Here there is variable x, that's why we have it where the variable is. Where there is no variable, you have it to be n. So with this, we are going to have 1 over n into summation x minus mu square minus 2 x bar minus mu. If you check this, n is common to both, you pick n out, they are going to have x bar minus mu plus n into x bar minus a mu squared. With this x bar minus mu, this x bar minus mu, meaning that will be squared. We are going to have it as 1 over n into summation x minus a mu squared minus 2n into x bar minus a mu squared plus a n into x bar minus a mu squared. As we can see that these two of these, this one of these, it will remain minus 1. So that you have a minus n into summation x minus a mu squared minus n hex bar minus a mu squared. So with this now, this n, this also n, this summation, remember that it ranges from a 1 to n. So meaning this n, it can be written like this, 1 over n into x minus a mu squared minus n into x bar minus a mu squared. So if you use this n to average it, you can use n to cut the n, we are going to have x minus a mu squared minus x bar minus a mu squared. Now, we are coming with sigma squared. We can now have our expected value of a sigma squared. Apply the expectation to both sides. Will be expected value of x minus mu squared minus expected value of x bar minus mu squared. When you take the expectation of a variable minus the parameter mu, that's our mean value, population mean value, we are going to have sigma squared minus, but the variance of x bar will be sigma squared over n. As we can see that we have already obtained our sigma squared, this is the one that make it to be biased. Then the bias of the sigma squared is now equal to minus sigma squared over n. But we can obtain the one they call corrective factor. Our corrective factor is when you have this expected value of sigma squared, which we know initially to be minus sigma squared over n, it can now be just take the LCM, you have a n, 1 in n will give you n sigma squared minus a sigma squared. As we can see that this sigma squared is common to both, we pick out the sigma squared, this one will mean what? We have a n minus a 1 over n. So this is the one we call a bias of n minus 1 is the one we call the correct factor of